We are now going to see the demonstration of this mixture, separation of this binary organic mixture which contains two components. As we had, if you have not seen my earlier video, please check that out, the link which we will give in the description box. But let's take a look again at the various steps that we need to go through to separate this mixture. First, we need to check for type. So in the type sequence, the first test is for an acid. An acid is tested with bicarbonate. This is bicarbonate. Okay, so let's add bicarbonate to this and check for effervescence. As you can see there, this very brisk effervescence taking place, indicating that we may have an acid present. Okay, can you see the effervescence? It's really clear, right? So we will just shake this very, very properly, okay, and check for reprecipitation. Adding a little more bicarbonate to ensure that all the acid is dissolved, because we need to ensure that both the components are separated completely. Brisk effervescence taking place over there. So we have managed to dissolve all the bicarbonate. Okay, there's no more all the acid by addition of the bicarbonate, and there's no more effervescence taking place. So we will filter this now. And check for reprecipitation. One precaution that we need to remember when doing the determination of type is to take the entire sample and not to take fresh mixture for every succeeding test. The sample has to be taken entirely for the first test, and the succeeding tests are done with the residue which is left after the preceding test. So we have got the filtrate over here. And let's check for reprecipitation. Remember, this is an acid, so reprecipitation will be checked with Conch HCl. I have concentrated HCl out here, which I'm going to add clockwise and check for reprecipitation. You will notice I am not getting any reprecipitation. However, I did get brisk effervescence on the addition of bicarbonate. So there could be a possibility that my acid is present, but because it is a water-soluble acid, that is why there is no reprecipitation. So let's check whether the medium is acidic enough before we declare that there is no reprecipitation. I will take a few drops of this filtrate and put it on a blue litmus paper. I will just show you this litmus paper. I will just put it on a blue litmus paper, and as you can see, it turns red, clearly indicating that the medium is acidic, but still there is no reprecipitation. No reprecipitation that follows effervescence indicates the presence of a water-soluble acid. We will be confirming the presence of a water-soluble component later if it is present. Okay, for the moment, it may be present is what we will assume. Okay, this is a filtrate in which we did not get any reprecipitation. This is the residue from that test. Let's proceed to determine the other component. Component A may be a water-soluble acid, but we will confirm its presence later. So I will just transfer this residue. Because we had effervescence, we know an acid is present. Hence, we need to remove all traces of that acid by giving washing with bicarbonate. So let's wash the residue with bicarbonate. It also helps me in transferring the residue. So let's go ahead and check for the next component. We have checked for an acid. We have assumed because we got effervescence, we might be having an acid, but we did not get reprecipitation, so it may be a water-soluble acid. Now let us check for the nature of component B, the second component. So we will now proceed for the test for phenol. Because we are working with very small quantities, it is advised that we do not try to pick up the residue from this, but instead we make a hole in the filter paper using a sealed capillary tube and just add the corresponding reagent. Okay, we have washed with bicarbonate, we have washed with water, and now we are proceeding to treat this with the reagents for phenol. The reagents for phenol are, the solubilizing reagent is sodium hydroxide. So we will add sodium hydroxide to this residue. As you can see, the residue is coming down. And then we will check for solubility and reprecipitation. We just give it a good shake. Okay, now we will filter this. I have a few drops of the filtrate and we will check for reprecipitation using Kong HCl. As you can see, I am not getting any reprecipitation. However, before we say there is no reprecipitation, let us confirm if the medium is acidic. We will check it with citrus. Let us see whether we have added sufficient amount of acid to reprecipitate a phenol. We are not going wrong over there. So we will transfer a few drops of this filtrate onto a litmus paper and let's check if blue turns red. As you can see, blue turns red. The medium is acidic enough, but still we have not got reprecipitation, it indicating that a phenol would be absent. So now that we know a phenol is absent, let us proceed with this residue that we have. Okay, now we will proceed for the test for a base. But before we proceed for the test for a base, we need to wash. Okay, here washing with NaOH is not required because we know that a phenol is not present. So only washing with water should be enough. So we will just add a little water to wash out whatever reagents were used in the earlier step. As you can see, we have now obtained a white residue after washing, which followed the test for a phenol. We got phenol absent. There was no reprecipitation. We also checked for the medium if it was acidic enough, and still there was no reprecipitation. So we assume that a phenol is absent. We have washed the residue with water, and now we will proceed for the test for base with this residue. So let's proceed to the test. We will make a hole in the filter paper, okay, that helps us in transference of that very small quantities of residue that we have. And we will add our reagent. Our reagent is 1:1 HCl. Let us prepare 1:1 HCl. We take about 1 ml of water. And to this we will add an equal quantity of concentrated HCl. Please remember the precaution of adding acid to water. So we will add HCl. Yeah, that should be our 1:1 HCl, equal quantities of water and HCl. And add HCl slowly to the water. We will now add this HCl to our residue. Try to dissolve it. As you can see, the white residue has come down, but let's check if it has dissolved. So we will shake it vigorously. And then proceed to filter. Transfer all the residue in case some of it is left behind by addition of a little more 1:1 HCl. We have got the filtrate over here and let's check for reprecipitation. Reprecipitation of a base is done with 20% NaOH. So let's add the 20% NaOH. And as you can see, there is no reprecipitation taking place with 20% NaOH. Let's check for the medium that we have added enough of NaOH in case we have gone wrong over there. This time we are checking for alkaline medium. Because we have added NaOH, we know that the medium must be alkaline for a base to be precipitated. Hence, let us check with litmus if the medium is alkaline enough. We will transfer a drop of this filtrate onto red litmus paper and it should turn blue. Let's check that. No, as you can see, it is still red, indicating that the medium is still not alkaline. This is an important precaution that we need to always do. When we are not getting reprecipitation, check for the medium of the filtrate. If you are adding an acid, the medium should be acidic. That means blue should turn to red. This time we are adding NaOH, that means the medium should be alkaline. That means red should turn to blue. So let's add a little more sodium hydroxide to ensure that the medium is acidic. Okay, let's check for the medium. Let's see that. As you can see, red has turned to blue, clearly indicating that the medium is alkaline, but still there is no reprecipitation. There is no reprecipitation. Hence, we can assume that our base is also absent. Now, we have, as you can see, that we have actually got indication of only one component. One component was the first reaction where we had got effervescence. We had assumed that an acid is present because effervescence was there, but we did not get reprecipitation, and therefore it may be a water-soluble acid. However, that is only a maybe factor, but we have got base absent, we have got phenol absent, and we have, therefore our only option for the second component could be, it could be neutral. Now, why are we so sure that it could be neutral? Because as you can see, we have got a residue left. This residue did not react either or give the test for a phenol. It did not give the test for a base, but it is left unchanged. So if a residue remains after all the tests, it is to be assumed that this component is a water insoluble neutral compound. So we have detected our two components. Component A may be a water soluble acid. Component B is a water insoluble neutral. Let us now confirm the presence of a water soluble acid. Let us see how we do that. So this is now we are going to confirm for the presence of the water-soluble component. We have taken a fresh amount of mixture and we are going to add water to it. We are going to shake it very vigorously. And then we are going to filter it. Can you see the filtrate coming down? It's a clear filtrate. And this clear filtrate, we are going to pour it onto a watch glass kept on an apparatus like this. We are going to start the burner. We have kept a water bath. And we are going to pour the clear filtrate on this watch glass. Okay. We will pour it onto this watch glass. And then we will start the burner. And evaporate it to dryness. We will evaporate the solution to dryness. The boiling water bath will heat up the watch glass from below. However, it's a controlled heating because there is a watch glass down, and we will evaporate it to dryness. You will see that a solid residue is observed on the watch glass. This happens because the water has evaporated and the water soluble compound has been left behind as a residue. This confirms the presence of the water-soluble component. Now, as far as separation of, first the type. So the type is water-soluble acid, and the second component that we had detected was water-insoluble neutral. Please note that whenever we have one of the components as water-soluble, the method of separation is always a physical method, and your separating agent will always be water. Irrespective of the chemical nature of the two components, the water soluble mixture will always be separated by the physical method using water.
To better understand the technique of separation for this mixture, please see the live demo in video 3. Remember to subscribe to my channel, Dr. J's Chem